What's going on, everybody? It's your boy X here. Man, I can't wait till I get my voice back. I can't wait and stuff like that. But, behold, we have the Game Awards nominees and stuff of 2021 and stuff like that. I think they just published this and stuff. So I always wanted to do a video like this, even before I started YouTube and stuff like that, to talk about the Game Awards. Now, the past few years, the Game Awards have been there has been some bright moments and then some like, Jeff, what are you doing and stuff like that. Like, so as far as like the show goes and stuff like that. Of course, everybody wants to tune into the game of the year and stuff like that, the most popular one. But for me, the show has been going like on a decline and stuff like that because it's been nothing but a bunch of advertisements and a bunch of filler and the show and stuff like that. But 2020, back in the Game Awards of, I think it was 2019 and stuff like that, Microsoft showed their next-gen consoles, so that was the groundbreaking moment and stuff like that. So, but then, it's hard to get like that. But, bro, next year, 2022, with the amount of games coming out and what games are coming out, 2022 Game of the Years, man, I can't wait to see that and stuff like that. But that's for then. We're hearing it now and stuff like that. So today, I'm going over every category. Well, probably start from right here because esports, I don't watch esports and stuff like that. So now I'm starting from right here, from the bottom to the top and stuff like that. For the game of the year. So now, and that I'm going to cast my votes and just talk about some games or in the categories because I saw a few, but I heard a certain game, Cyberpunk, is in here. CG Projekt Red, how much did you pay to put your game in here? It's crazy, but if you guys do enjoy today's video, make sure you smash the like button, subscribe if you're new to the channel, make sure you check out the channel so much. And let's get into these nominees, shall we? So start off first, most anticipated game. Let's see what we got. All right. So we got, for the most anticipated game, we got Elden Ring. Which I heard good things, but I'm not into the Souls game. So, God of War, Boy of War, Boy, Ragnarok. We got God of War Ragnarok. Now, I know this is probably up there where everybody's most anticipated game. Like, oh my God, God of War, stuff like that. I come for new fans, but I've been a fan since the PS2 days. I played every game, so seeing Kratos get as much love as he did back in the day and now stuff like that, it just warms my heart and stuff like that. So, God of War Ragnarok, of course, for Horizon Forbidden West, the sequel to one of the biggest Sony exclusive stuff like that was from like 2017, stuff like that. So of course Horizon, beautiful game and stuff like that. Like the graphics are gonna be jaw dropping. Like what we saw in that gameplay teaser, especially, that's why I say this. If you could get your hands, I know it's impossible to get a PS5. Any way you can get it, if you gotta pay monthly for it, do a payment program or whatever, stuff like that, you'll be doing yourself an injustice of playing this game on PS4. It also look good, but you want to go ahead and spend that on PS5. So this game, I'm looking forward to it with these. So these two, my two, Zelda Breath of the Wild, the sequel. I have a Switch. I'm planning to get the Switch OLED. Now I don't play a lot of Nintendo games no more and stuff like that. I might play Smash here and there, but I never got into the Zelda series. So I don't know anything about it, but I know a lot of people are really hyped. And of course, Zelda Breath of the Wild and stuff like that. I think one game of the year, I forgot when it came out, 2017 and stuff like that. So of course, this is a heavy hitter game right here. And Starfield from Bethesda Games and stuff like that. Of course, me being me, I gotta go ahead. I have to go ahead and I had to give it to God of War and stuff like that. I'm gonna give it to God of War. I apologize if my voice is scratchy and stuff like that, but I'm gonna give it onto God of War and stuff. Even though Horizon is looking appetizing, but yeah. But moving on and stuff like that. Best Indie. You already know. I was supposed to get this game, but I had other things to do, stuff like that, and I was working, stuff like that, and, you know, the struggle got real and stuff, so I couldn't play, but I'm planning to pick it up probably at the end of the month and stuff like that, when they come out with the physical copies and stuff like that, the game. Kena, Bridge of Spirits. I heard this game made grown men cry and stuff like that. This game was challenging, but it was beautiful and stuff. It was like a Pixar movie and stuff like that. So I was like, wow, stuff like that. I was seeing some people play it and stuff, you know, amazing. So I'm definitely gonna play this one and stuff like that. Don't know when, but definitely gonna play this one. So of course, I don't know any of these, but Kenna, you get my vote. Next one. Content Creator of the Year. This is the problem with this category, that they just put, you know, the highest, like, YouTubers, like the YouTubers that have the most subscribers, most views, stuff like that, but kind of be the most, like, iffy and stuff like that. So I wish that they made a thing to, like, the Content Creator of, like, the year, like, in, you know, like on the bomb and stuff like that, like, or the up and coming creator and stuff like that, like category, because just shining your light on the people that are already made and stuff like that kind of makes, like, the people that are trying to branch out and trying to, you know, make their voice heard, stuff like that, kind of get not shit on, but, like, overshadowed and stuff like that. So Jeff Keighley, if you can make a up and coming content creator of the year, that'd be perfect for the little guys like us. Best multiplayer game. Best multiplayer. Okay, whatever. So we got Back 4 Blood, a game that I reviewed, and holy crap and stuff. That's if it will. Knockout City, which that's free for PS Plus. I gotta download that stuff for that. It Takes Two. If you guys have never played It Takes Two, I highly, highly, highly recommend it. Now, it's a game that got slept on, stuff like that, but it also got nominated for a whole bunch of awards and stuff like that. But It Takes Two, a fantastic game, especially, I think it was one of the best co-op games and stuff like that, easily, and stuff like that, of the year. Had a blast with it. I think me and my brother played it, a blast, stuff like that. Loved it. Monster Hunter Rise, New World, that looks interesting, but it's only on PC, so can't really play it and stuff, and I don't know what this is, but I was gonna go right to Back 4 Blood because best multiplayer, but It Takes Two, that game was so fun. The boss battles, to the levels, to, you know, to the humor and stuff like that. It Takes Two. Now some people say, "Oh, what? Like it Takes Two and stuff." If you never played it, please go play it, stuff like that. And I think if you buy the game, your friend or whoever you want to play with, I can play it for free because on the game has a buddy pass. So if one of you owns the game, your friend can play do the whole game for free. So that's good, but. It Takes Two, you got my vote. Best sports and racing game. Now, I'm not into racing games or sports games at all. I have zero interest, and I've always been that way. Even when sports was in its glorious days back in the PS2. Well, that's not true, because I love the older WWE games. WWE SmackDown versus Raw. SmackDown Just Bring It and stuff. Those games. It's classic and stuff like that. But now I don't really care. I've never been into racing games unless it was Burnout. Or kind of Need for Speed, but mostly Burnout. Awesome. But you have F1 21, FIFA 22. I'm surprised how this got nominated, because EA. Forza Horizon 5. I've been hearing this game looks photorealistic. Photorealistic and stuff like that. It looks photorealistic and stuff like that. This game, I mean, nothing but praise and stuff like that. You know, people were saying, no, this saved Xbox, which probably Halo's gonna do that and stuff like that. But this game and Halo really push Xbox like up a tier and stuff like that. So, because I never played it, but I might play with my fiance and stuff like that. But as far as like racing simulators, no. Hot Wheels, they made a Hot Wheels game. And then Riders, this was the Ubisoft game, stuff like that. It looked interesting, but I never gave it a chance. But I was gonna vote for Horizon, because you know, I wanted to support Xbox, stuff like that. You know, I wanted to support it, stuff like that, because my game was getting praised. I've seen gameplay of it and stuff like that. It looks stunning, nice. So I'm gonna give it to Horizon and stuff. Why not? And stuff. You know, I don't play Horizon games, but let's give it to Forza. Best family game. Now, this is literally, they should rename it Best Nintendo Game, because Nintendo got the family friendly games on lock and stuff like that. If you want family friendly, look no further than Nintendo. But you got It Takes Two, Mario Party Superstars. There's a Mario Party. Pokemon. You got Super Mario 3D World. Browser. And Wario and stuff. Wow, so best family. Got, I don't know which one you will vote for, but I can only vote for a game that I played. So even though I don't play Mario games like that no more and stuff like that on Nintendo games, so I can only vote for a game that I played, which was this. Best fighting game. So I don't play fighting games and stuff like that. Best role-playing game. Now, I love my RPGs and stuff like that. I love my RPGs. Love them and stuff like that. So let's see what we have, shall we? And stuff. Do you see this? Jeff. I wish I can scream. Jeff, what is this? What am I looking at? Why is this game here? Why is this game here? Why is this game nominated? Why? Were you sleeping under a rock when this game came out? Do you know the history behind this game and what happened and how groundbreaking, how broken this game was in the industry? Why am I seeing it on my screen? Jeff, please. Why am I seeing it on my screen? Cyberpunk 2077 for nominated for best role-playing game. You couldn't even finish the game, of how broken it was. You couldn't even experience the true stuff of how broken the game was. And it was broken for me. Like, I couldn't even get invested into the story and the characters because it was crashed. I never had a game crash so many times before. The glitches, the game breaking, but the... You already know the whole history about Cyberpunk, so I'm not even going to go into that, but Cyberpunk 2077, hell no, absolutely not. I don't know why this game is in the game, the Game Awards. The game does not deserve no awards, absolutely not, and stuff like that. A broken mess, they wanted to rush it out, just so that they can make money, but it backfired on them. I wish Rockstar, Activision, EA took notes of Cyberpunk, but I guess not. So, yeah. But best role-playing game, I haven't played these. This is not going to get my vote because Cyberpunk is the only game that I played in this category, but hell no. Hell no, it's stuff. I will not vote for that. I can't believe that. So, unfortunately, I'm going to skip this. Best action and adventure game. Ooh. We got something here. I just finally woke up. We got something here. Oh man, you got some heavy hitters in this category. You got Guardians of the Galaxy. If you guys have seen my review of that game, fantastic game. Square Enix literally made up for what they did. Well, not Square Enix itself and stuff like that. Well, Square Enix and Crystal Dynamics, but made up for their second attempt of a Marvel game. Nailed it out the park. From the story, even the combat, which at first I was like, eh, but then at the end I was like, yo, this is fun and stuff like that. Fantastic. If you haven't played Guardians of the Galaxy, please go play it and stuff like that. People really loved it and stuff like that. And it was a shock. I wasn't even planning on getting this game and stuff like that. I forgot it was exists. Until I heard some things about it, I was like, yeah, let me pick it up. And not being a comic book, you know, head and stuff like that, and not really knowing about the Guardians of the Galaxies, this game made me care about them more than what they did in the movies. So, fantastic game, stuff like that. Easily a vote and stuff. Metroid Dread, I know a lot of people love this game, stuff like that. I haven't been paying too much attention to Nintendo, but I can easily see this game, you know, going head to head and stuff like that. You know, a lot of people love this game and stuff like that, especially when it came out. So, I actually might pick it up and play it. But I want to get the Switch OLED first. I know I did a whole rant. My older video did a whole rant on Switch OLED and stuff like that. But I might pick it up because I do love OLED screens and stuff like that. And they look the best. And, you know, I just like new hardware and stuff like that. Even though it was a copy and paste and stuff like that from Nintendo, but I'll still pick it up. But this I'll actually play and stuff. Psychonauts 2. Now I heard a lot of good things about this game. This game made a lot of people feel like a child again, like playing on the PS2. It was like, because it sounds like the PS2 type graphics, so it really reminded people of classic gaming. You know, lay back, not serious, not sweating, the difficulty and stuff like that. Really a fun game. I was really going to get into this game. I still want to get, maybe it's on sale for Black Friday. I definitely want to pick this up and stuff like that because I love games like this and stuff like that. But I've been looking at it, I'm like, and stuff like that. Now, I never played the first one, but I never played the first one back on PS2 stuff like that. But I will play this. So these two games, I will play stuff like that, especially this one. So why not? So Psychonauts 2. Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart. This might win it. I mean, if we being honest, this game might win it. This category, just because Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart. Whew, what a hell of a game. Oh my god, from the visuals to the gameplay, even the story was and stuff like that. Of course, it was cheesy, but you know, I enjoyed the story, but the visuals and the gameplay, fantastic stuff like that. This game really showed what the PS5 was capable of and stuff like that. So definitely, I could easily see this win, but Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart, I have it and stuff. Love that game. No, I beat it, I played it, and I reviewed it and stuff. Resident Evil Village, my first PS5 game. Now this was before I got my PS5. I got my PS5 in like late April. So you know, I got this game on PS5, but I couldn't play it until I got it. But this was my first PS5 game and stuff, and I actually really enjoyed Resident Evil Village. Now, I'm not like a hardcore fan like that, you know, of the series, but these reboots and stuff like that and sequels are really like good. The visuals to the gameplay, stuff like that, and the story, fantastic and stuff. So definitely all heavy hitter games. You can't go wrong for either or, but if I gotta say best adventure game, so best adventure will combat. Now I haven't played these two, so I'm not gonna vote for them. Resident Evil Village, it's a great game, but it's not like that in your face and stuff like that. But I'm leaving between Ratchet and Clank or Guardians of the Galaxy. And I might have to go with Guardians of the Galaxy. Just because of that story. I'm giving the Guardians a slight edge. Even though Ratchet and Clank has better combat. But that story and getting immersed and stuff like that, I gotta get the slight edge to Guardians of the Galaxy. But, you know, of course, you know, let me know what you vote for. But, of course, I gotta give it to Guardians of the Galaxy. Just a slight edge. It's a slight, because Ratchet could easily overtake that. But, you know, immerse wise and stuff like that, I'll give this like edge to Guardians of the Galaxy and stuff. Moving on, best action game. Oh boy, do we got something. Now of course I haven't played this. We got Back 4 Blood really out here getting nominated. I mean, Back 4 Blood, holy crap. You want to talk about action and heart pounding and frustration, sweat dripping, but no further. Deathloop. Now, I played Deathloop. I don't remember if I reviewed it or not. The game is fun. The gunplay and the game, how you know, try to assassinate targets and, you know, go through the world and stuff. But that loot mechanic and stuff like that, I really, really feeling it and stuff like that. It was a lot of issues and stuff like that. That how I would have flooped and stuff like that. So that's how I can never really get like into it. But I can see why it's in this category. Far Cry 6, the game that I dropped. Well, I didn't drop. I stopped playing it, which I had to get back into it and stuff like that. But Far Cry 6, you already know a Far Cry game. They're all similar. Massive open worlds, you know, tons of missions and stuff like that. That's why these games are so hard for me to beat, because I just sink hours into them and I'll have a lot of time for that and stuff like that to do that. But Far Cry 6, stuff like that, what I have played, from the gunplay, the story, and the environment, I really enjoyed and stuff like that. But and Returnal and stuff like that. Now, I'm not into roguelike games stuff like that. Where you die and you gotta start all over. But a lot of people did love Returnal and stuff like that. Just not my type of game and stuff like that. But no, I can see why. But yeah, but best action adventure game for me that I put the most time into, Back 4 Blood and stuff. Even though that gunplay and its issues and stuff like that it has, but man, did that game get me on the edge of my seat and heart pounding and stuff like that and frustrated. So I'm gonna vote for Back 4 Blood and stuff. Back 4 Blood, you got one vote for me. Oh, okay. So this category is for like settings and stuff like that in the menu to help people with disabilities and stuff like that, like me. With disabilities and stuff like that. So okay, so you got Far Cry 6, Forza Horizon, Guardians of the Galaxy, which had a lot of system, like, you know, you can tweak the game to how you want it. Ratchet and Clank, I don't remember having a lot of that. And this, I haven't played Forza, so I don't know. Ratchet, I don't think it had that many discs. I never played, so Far Cry 6. It does have a lot of settings, but not on the level of Guardians and stuff like that. You can literally tweak of how much damage you want to take and stuff like that, or dish out. Of course, Guardians. Best indie. Is there more to say? Kenna, go ahead and take that. Without a doubt. Without hesitation, best audio design. Oh boy, we got Deathloop, which had good audio stuff like that. Forza Horizon 5, Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart, Resident Evil Village, and Returnal. Bro, aside Deathloop, all these all heavy hitting games. Best audio design. Now, right out the gate, I'm going to go with Ratchet and Clank. Because it's really like the only game that really made me convinced of, oh my god, like this could be next gen, stuff like that. Like, what Insomnia did for Rift Apart, incredible. Even though Horizon 5 is groundbreaking, Resident Evil Village, it is great, and Returnal, even though it's not my type of game, but, you know, I still have, you know, I respect for it. But of course, I'm going to vote for Ratchet and Clank for best audio design. Best score, best music in the game. So best one that has the best OST and stuff. I haven't played that. That game does not exist. Moving over. Deathloop, which had a good OST. Guardians of the Galaxy. Guardians of the Galaxy OST was hitting, especially if you listen to some of the songs that get you pumping and stuff like that. Even though I'm not even to like the, you know, rock or the classic 80s and stuff like that, Guardians of the Galaxy OST to me was a standout. Like, it got you immersed and stuff like that, and Nier, which I never really got to Nier, but between these two, this game does not exist. CD Projekt, Jeff, what's the game doing here? I'm going to vote for Guardians. Yes. Best art direction. Ooh. I'm about to go straight for Kenna and stuff. But I saw. I saw Ratchet and Clank. Deathloop looked good, but like stand out is between Kenna and Ratchet. But I might have to get a slight edge to Ratchet, because again, Ratchet and stuff like that, both games look incredible and stuff like that, but Ratchet really did like blew my mind. It was like, oh my god, like this what next gen could be. You know, when I saw Kenna and stuff like that, it was beautiful. But Ratchet, so even though I would easily vote for Kenna, but I would just have to vote for Ratchet for this one. Best narrative. Oh, best storytelling. Oh, here we go. We got Deathloop. I don't know how Hagen got nominated like that. I don't know how Hagen got nominated. Okay. It Takes Two was a great game. A great co-op game, stuff like that. And the story wasn't that bad either, stuff like that. It Takes Two. Life is Strange. I don't really care about that. Guardians of the Galaxy for best and storytelling. You guys see my review. That story and Guardians of the Galaxy and just how it was told, the pacing goes crazy and stuff like that. And Psychonauts, which I haven't played. I'm sorry. Listen. I'm not biased to Guardians of the Galaxy, but as I call it, what I see it, Guardians of the Galaxy has a better story than it takes two and stuff. Like, just, you know, it was just, you know, I just loved it and stuff like that. But of course, you know, vote for what you think that had the better story. But for me, Guardians of the Galaxy, easy. Oh man, we're nearing the end to Game of the Year stuff. So of course, and so I know it's been a long video and stuff like that. So if I did make it to the end and stuff like that, I really do appreciate it and stuff like that, because you know I want to talk about these games and stuff like that and get my thoughts on it. So, best game direction for Outstanding Creative. Okay. I'm about to give it to It Takes Two. For best game direction and outstanding, like, and creativeness. I mean, Deathloop is a unique game with time loop mechanic. It Takes Two is a unique game because of the co-op aspect and stuff like that. Returnal, it's like a roguelike game, it's too. Psychonauts, it's like classic PS2 gaming. Imagine and Clank. But, you know, Ratchet & Clank wasn't, like, unique and stuff like that because, you know, we've seen it before and stuff in the gameplay, so. Do I give it to Deathloop? Or do I give it to It Takes Two? I'll give it to It Takes Two and stuff. Just because, you know, it was very unique and stuff like that. I did really enjoy that game and stuff like that. So, best game direction. So, I think this is the last category. And last, but not least, ladies and gentlemen, the only category that people actually care about, sadly, Jeff Keighley. Game of the Year. Game of the Year. Oh, man. The pinnacle of, like, achievement that your game can achieve. Now looking at this list, it's a good list. Deathloop nominated for Game of the Year. I wouldn't say all that. It Takes Two nominated for Game of the Year. Listen, I love It Takes Two, but Game of the Year? Metroid Dread, which I haven't played, but I heard great things about it. Psychonauts 2? Man, I wonder who picked these games and stuff like that. And stuff, but I don't know. Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart and Resident Evil Village. this is like unique. List. Okay, again, 2021 has been a slow year for gaming. A lot of games have gotten delayed until 2022 because of what's going on and stuff. So this year wasn't going to be groundbreaking of if God of War came out or Horizon came out, stuff like that. But next year will be crazy, stuff like that. So a lot of games did get delayed. So we didn't really get too many like high quality games, a lot of broken games and stuff like that. So I mean I can't go wrong, but you know, you can't really go wrong. You know, people love Metroid Dread, people love Ratchet, love Resident Evil, It Takes Two. If I'm gonna vote for game of the year, now comment down below, what would you guys vote for? I haven't played this, so I can't vote on something I haven't played. Deathloop, in my opinion, is not game of the year. I don't know why it's in this category and stuff. It's a cool game, but it's not game of the year worthy and stuff. It Takes Two, fantastic game, but like game of the year, I don't know about that one. But the only thing I can think of is Ratchet and Clank. That really like broke out, stuff like that, got praise and really pushed the limits of PS5. Or I guess there's something about Resident Evil, but Ratchet and Clank really, I do think, stood out the most in this list. Now, you know, if you had Guardians, if you had Kena: Bridge of Spirits, stuff like that in this list, which Kena should have been in place of Deathloop. But okay, Psychonauts, I don't know, but yeah, so I'm gonna vote for Ratchet and Clank, why not, and stuff like that. So even though I vote for Ratchet and Clank, I know people are like, yeah, Ratchet and Clank because of this category, it is one of the more standout games and stuff, but my personal game of the year is Guardians of the Galaxy. That's my personal game of the year. That game really surprised me. Totally surprised me out of left field, especially coming from Square Enix. Really surprised me, stuff like that. So my personal game of the year is Guardians of the Galaxy and stuff. Yes, people was like, what did this man just say? Yes, and stuff like that. Just because of the shock factor of how much I enjoyed it and stuff like that. I'm currently doing another playthrough of it, so that's my personal one. But of course, in this list, I'm going to go with my boy Ratchet and stuff like that, because Ratchet really did the damn thing this past summer and stuff like that. And yeah, so those are all the nominations and stuff like that of the 2021 game of the Game Awards and stuff like that. What do you guys think about this and stuff like that? And what do you guys vote for from each category and stuff like that? You know, and what was your personal game of the year and stuff like that? No, let me know down in the comments below. If you guys did enjoy today's video, make sure you smash the like button, subscribe if you're new to the channel. Make sure you be out to the channel so much. I do not know why I say that fast, but it's funny. But yeah, and so just let me know what you guys vote for and stuff like that. And yeah, so I'll catch you guys in my next video. Take it easy. Peace.